Hi, my name's Sarah Frankish. I work for Ellicosoft Pty in Australia, and I work with our stairs design and manufacture software called Staircon. So the aim of the video is really to demonstrate a little bit of what Staircon can do and how it does it, but also how it links through into our Staircon CAM software, creating programs very automated. Way of creating programs that then run on Maestro for your SCM and Morbidelli machines. So I wanted to demonstrate a little bit of what Staircon can do first of all. So let's just put in some very basic customer information. You can choose to fill all of this out and add more info if you want to as well. Finished floor to floor height, floor thickness and flooring thickness for the bottom of the stair. And then we can put in a floor opening. So we just keep, I'm just going to do sort of a straight flight to start off with. A shortcut there just to indicate where we exit the stair at the top. So once we click apply, you can see the stair appears. We start off with a more basic one. So we can just have a house stair and we just change the material override here. What might be a good idea is that I show you the 3D at the same time. So if I just tile the windows, and then you should see the 3D changing when we change the model. So that's sort of just a standard closed string model. You can have open rise. So we can just change that. And you have safety risers on there instead. We could have a cut string. Let's try that one. And then again, just making sure the material is selected. Iron balustrade, just to change all those balusters to black painted. And then what we can do, we have like the mono string or center string models as well. And I have a model in there with a steel center string and some glass. So if you see, it sort of updates straight away, places the string over to the wall side. And then we just need to move that over using a couple of parameters in the string settings here. We can just move that over like this, make sure the holes go with it. And then we just need to open up our elevation view. So Staircon's not predominantly steel stair manufacturing software, and you won't get any production details for this other than maybe the holes in the steps for your glass and for your plates underneath. But it does give you a good visual. I'll just choose those black standoffs there. So once we have, you can see these are plates. So these are just 3D files giving us our plates here. What we could do is add on some balustrade at the top. It will automatically select the right balustrade for the stair model. So it places your glass around. One thing it doesn't do is automatically place the standoffs around the floor opening, but we can quickly add those in. So if I just put in a couple of helplines, I know a lot more care and time would be taken on this than what I'm doing. But I don't want to make the video too long. So once we have our hole patterns in there, we can then add in our glass standoffs, make sure they're the same finish as on our stair. And then you have your stair like this. So what's important here? Let's get some production data. So we'll have everything toggled on production data wise. We can have a quick look through. So this is all you would get for a string. It's literally just giving you the shape, but it will give you your holes for your treads, for your plates and your glass standoffs as well. And quite important, you also get your glass balustrade, which could be sent via DXF to your glazier. So from there, we can print these production drawings and we can also create some reports. So different reports. We could have customer reports, production reports, but you'll see I've already generated some here. So you could have your plan view and a 3D, information about your glass, the production drawings all printed out to go to the workshop, the shop floor. And then there's a bit more information here. So once you have all of those, the next stage would be, if we were producing some of the parts, is to actually send this into Staircon CAM. So you can see it pulls through the name that we put in at the beginning. So I'm going to send that to CAM and I'm going to leave it there, and then we can actually start another drawing. So let's get rid of some of this. Start a new drawing. Eventful names, test two. So we'll leave the floor to floor. For this, it's not so important. But if we did curved work, there's lots of ways of making different curved stairs, but one of the nicest features in here for a curved stair that has two radius outside and inside, we could use this. So instead of that particular model, I know these stairs are pretty popular in Australia at the moment, so we can increase the number of risers. And if you wanted to ensure that you have your 250 going on the inside, 400 mil from the inside of the strings, or the outside, whichever you need to test to, then Staircon will automatically adjust the stair to show you this. So you can see we might need to change our materials. The materials have come through. So then you have sort of a very impressive curved stair. And again, we can produce this fairly quickly. We can add in, use our report system again. If I just put in a couple of helplines, and we can then split our strings and therefore our handrails, and then produce all of our parts. So at this stage, you do your bill of materials again, we print all the production drawings. What we have, these are our curved strings here, and then we send that one test two into CAM. Okay, so then the last stair. So just a fairly sort of basic U-shaped stair to start off with. So if we were to, let's just change these. 7, 2, 3. So we have walls all the way round. We'll copy the walls, so it's easy to add landing balustrade on. Tell Staircon where you exit the stair and put in some steps. So we'll put in a landing, make sure it's facing the right way, and maybe just increase the width here. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll just use a really sort of simple model here, maybe that iron one. And so you see here 2653, we're not quite met 2700, so we can overwrite that, and then Staircon will indicate to us the parameters we may want to change. I'm just going to increase this landing depth. So we can okay like this. And we can look at our other views. So we have our elevation views. Now, what I'm going to do is delete out these posts. So because I mentioned about curved stairs, we can take a measurement here, 200, and we can say that this string is actually a curved string with a radius of 100. Excuse me. And then we can move our string back. So if we have a look at that in elevation, it's likely to need a little bit of straightening out. If we have a look in our 3D, it doesn't look too bad. We'd spend some time just maybe straightening in between here. Probably also look at putting some connections between our curved parts. So before I go too far, if we're going to produce this, let's just split this into two. So function split string, And then we can take care of what we need to in here. So straightening between points to try and keep a nice uniform sort of transition on the radius. So if I just highlight here, and we want to use the holes in the handrail end, and then I have some hole patterns set up, and then the holes for the stringer ends. And then if these need to move, that's okay. Well, that one needs to move, so we can just move that up there. So we're pretty happy with that. We can check our 3D and we can produce our reports and everything that we need to for the factory. So again, on different parts, there's our curved string with our connections, there's the opposite one. And right down at the bottom, toggled everything on. So we've got balusters and everything. Right down at the bottom of our list, we have our two pieces of handrail. One thing I forgot. This handrail doesn't have a profile at the moment. So we will just make probably didn't need to produce absolutely everything here. So we'll just straighten up again. That's the wrong button. Right, so what we'll do is produce that once more again and send that one. Test 3 says here in Staircon CAM. So then we can open Staircon CAM. Now it is possible to bring through multiple jobs. So if you prefer to batch work and maybe produce all of your strings over morning and then post in the afternoon, you can work like that. You could bring through multiple jobs. They will all have a different folder where the strings will go into, and the posts will go into a different folder, all with the different program name. So what I want to do is just if we place the strings and let's produce one of the curved handrails. And we'll do one of the curved strings as well. And then really, like I say, I want to show how quick Staircon will produce. So at this stage, what you see here, this text is basically the program. So the program's been written and produced and sent to a folder somewhere on the computer. We can simulate these programs, we can make changes in Staircon CAM. But the simulation, probably that's more interesting, is the simulation on the machine, because by then you know whether the program is going to machine okay and you can verify it. So what we can do here, we import the script. So I'm hoping, I don't know where my test 2 is. So if we go into here, test 3, and we have one of our curved handrails. Eventually, we have to save this, and we can then ask the machine to simulate what it's about to do. So I'm going to whack the speed up because obviously this video is becoming quite long. But I think the important thing to remember here is that the programs have been written and they are ready to run on the CNC machine. And the simulation gives us a really good idea of if that program is going to machine okay, if we're using the right tools, if the end result is going to be okay without actually putting timber on. So that is one very quick wreath handrail. I won't bore you with showing you absolutely everything. This is the two strings that's come through. With this, if you want to see the simulation, then we'd need to just increase this material size. It doesn't bring through sort of an updated material size, but we can save that and we can then simulate it in the same way as long as we have this turned off, because otherwise the whole string disappears from the board. But at least you can see it being machined. So, and then the only other one really that might be interesting is the curved string. So Staircon CAM produces two programs for the curved string. So we can have one program and then have the machining, have a pause in the program to rotate, or you can produce both sides in as part of one program. So again, I'm just going to whack this right up at speed. I do get some extra machining on this, but just like a cleanup cut. So then it turns into a five axis and creates this concave machining. Reference cut, and then this is machining the faces that would be connected to each other. So because that's just the concave side, then what we can do is import. Oh, I'm just going to replicate that. Once we save it, we can simulate it again. Just speed that right up. So this is just taking the corners off, really. So we don't have such a heavy cut on this next machining. So then this is the convex machining. And that's your curved string. So that's it really, guys. I just wanted, like I say, to show you sort of how quickly we can get from design into Staircon CAM and then basically onto the machine and into Maestro. So yeah, I hope you found it interesting. If you do want to see a little bit more about Staircon, feel free to contact me. My contact details are there, or you can go onto our website and you'll be able to find any details you need on there as well. Okay, thank you. Take care. Bye.